Google's June and July core algorithm update could have a huge impact on your business. And in this video, we're gonna go through how do you fight back against your SEO rankings against this algorithm update, which is having a huge, huge impact on so many businesses. Some businesses that were ranking high in SEO are now seeing the fastest drops in their SEO rankings in history. And there's a couple key reasons that this is happening. And in this video, we're gonna bring you through a little bit of the facts as to like what Google released, the two key facts that are causing this. But the first thing I wanna start with is Google, like what is Google? Google is essentially hand delivering people the best possible search result they can for a search that's made on Google, right? So Google's constant job with these algorithm updates is defining what is quality content. Meaning if I type in, you know, chiropractor near me, what is the right search result to show for that keyword as an example? And what Google has done is you've seen, we went through, you know, algorithm updates where Google prioritizes backlinks. Then we went through algorithm updates where Google prioritizes the infrastructure or the architecture of a website, how fast a website loads, right? Now, Google has redefined with this new algorithm update the meaning of user, or also referred to as page experience. So before I explain to you how you can dial in your page or user experience according to Google's terms based on this algorithm update, before I explain that to you, I'm gonna have Ben explain the two key changes that are happening as a piece of this algorithm update. Ben?
No problem. So the first key to this update is the fact that websites within content or websites that have been classified as YMYL sites have received a lower ranking with this update. The second thing is the rise of something that I'm calling scraper spam. And it is a huge, huge consequence of this algorithm update that's causing all sorts of Twitter backlash, all sorts of comment backlash.
So YMYL, I believe you told me it stands for your money, your life. So this is essentially websites that have to do with giving personalized advice around people's problems. Is that a safe way to?
Yes, so, and it's about very personal problems, meaning that if you offer health advice about, you know, how to solve an illness or something like that, or if you're offering advice about how to handle an injury case with law firms, or if you're offering financial advice that tells you how to invest in stocks, any of those kinds of businesses or websites that offer that advice saw a hit in their rankings.
Yep, and the reason I think as part of this we'll talk about what deceptive content is because a lot of this free content around people's personal problems is deceptive as in Google's eyes, meaning it's a sales pitch. It's not legitimate SEO content. So YMYL rankings, go ahead, do some of your own research. If you own a business, you have a website, do some of your own research and decide and determine, are you a YMYL business? And are you going to be therefore more affected by this? The second thing I wanna go into, Ben, is thin content sites you mentioned,
yeah.
Meaning contents that have pages that have really thin amounts of content on them, those pages are gonna plummet?
They are definitely seeing a drop in ranking. So when I say thin content, that means that if you've been sporadic with your blog posts, or if you only have a single type of content on your website, Google is seeing that and ranking your page accordingly, meaning that if you've been depending on a single blog post to drive traffic to your website, it's going to cost you. And this algorithm update, whether it's now or later, you're going to see that drop in traffic.
Wow. So thin content, this is a lesson for me. I thought thin content meant short pages, but you're also saying thin content is websites that have one page that outranks the others. So that's a big insight. The next thing I want to go into on the news side is scraper spam.
Cool.
It seems to me like this is essentially making it easier for people to scrape your content, copy it, and repurpose it. Is that?
No, so what scraper spam is basically these new web pages are coming up, and what they're doing is they're taking the highest rated SEO websites and they're just putting those articles on a single page.
Mm.
And so what this is doing is you're seeing all of these web pages with these high authority domains with these beautiful websites being aggregated into a single page and displacing the original creators of those content. So what this means is that that blog post that's been referenced thousands and thousands of times is now being outranked by someone who came onto the scene literally 2 or 3 months ago. All of your hard work, Bill, has just gone down the tube.
Yeah. So scraper spam is a big risk because what people want is the concept of information buffets, right? They want the ability to get their entire problem solved on one page, and that requires long form content. And this means that if you have piecemeal content that someone else could repurpose and create an information buffet on it, your page could be at risk. So I'm gonna talk quickly about the user experience movement that needs to happen now. According to Google's algorithm update, user experience first is the name of the game. So there's four specific factors that I wanna talk about. Number one, interactivity, okay? Interactivity is essentially a sign to Google as, are people interacting with your web pages? Okay, interaction can be measured by time on the page, but more importantly, are people clicking stuff on the page? Okay, are there buttons on the page? Are there internal links that link to other pages on your website on the page? This turns up the interactivity score. Another thing is obviously mobile, 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 mobile. We say this till we're blue in the face, and yet nobody redesigns their website for mobile first. And that's a big deal, okay? So if your website looks crappy on mobile devices, Google's algorithm can pick it up like that, okay? The next thing I wanna talk about is deceptive content. What's deceptive content? And how does this relate to the YMYL concept that Ben brought up? Well, it's pretty interesting. Deceptive content doesn't mean you're getting ripped off or you're going into like a penny stock scheme or some crazy pyramid scheme, okay? Getting deceptive content can be something framed as help. That's really a sales pitch. How many of you have seen this with local businesses that rank for Chiropractor Philadelphia or Injury Attorney Philadelphia? And you go onto the page of this law firm that's ranking first for Injury Lawyer Philadelphia, and there's nothing of value on the page. It's literally like a sales pitch on Injury Lawyer Philadelphia. The question is that deceptive, right? Well, it's not unethically deceptive. However, the fourth point I wanted to bring up is regarding searcher intent, it is deceptive. What does that mean? Well, the person who is typing in Personal Injury Lawyer Philadelphia, who's to say they want to be sold by a personal injury lawyer on why to choose them? They may still be in the research phase. They may still be vetting out personal injury lawyers in Philadelphia. They may want a rating site that rates all the personal injury lawyers in Philadelphia so they can make an informed decision based on reviews or third-party testimonials. So it's not that it's deceptive in unethical terms, but some of the content you have on your website, if you're a service provider and you're ranking high for keywords that, you know, when people are in need of a solution provider, you may get ranked as deceptive content, which can plummet your user experience score on the pages on your website. So the solution to this is obviously creating searcher intent matched better content. So searcher intent matched better content means what people type in is exactly what you're giving them. Meaning the intent behind what they're typing in. Okay, so for example, we do a lot of work with attorneys nationwide. When someone types in car accident settlement, what they actually want, and we've learned this through studies, is a car accident settlement calculator. So it's funny, if you go on Google and you type in car accident settlement amounts, you'll see organic results pop up that say car accident calculator. Well, because the people who are interested in how much their case is worth in a car accident case, they actually want a calculator, right? So what's happening is Google, through their semantic matching, is starting to figure out more and more and more when someone types in X, what do they really want? Do they want a sales pitch page? Or do they want an objective educational piece of information? Kind of like what Ben and I are doing right now for you. We're giving you objective information so you can better navigate your way through this algorithm update, right? So Google would like this in SEO world. So another solution that Ben came up with is the importance of diversification of your content, right? So with all these algorithm changes, if you're not diversified in your marketing, there's gonna be a problem. Like, you need to be ranking high on SEO. You need to be ranking high on your organic and your Google Maps and your blog posts. You also need to be you need to be spending money on advertisements, because advertisements are the only way to guarantee that your website's gonna show up regardless of algorithm changes, okay? So we have to focus more on diversifying our marketing plans for our businesses. We have to focus more on longer form content that matches searcher intent. We also have to budget for spending money on paid advertisements, because remember, YouTube and Google, Facebook and Instagram, LinkedIn, okay, all these places that seem like good charitable social media sites and search engines, are they publicly traded then?
Last time I checked, I believe they were.
Yeah, they're publicly traded. And how do they make money, Ben?
I think they make money by monetizing their platforms.
And yeah, clicking ads is how they make money on platforms. So again, the world is going towards, we believe, paid advertising. And we see this time and time again, the people who grow the fastest spend the most on paid advertising. And they're not playing this long-term cross your fingers and wait game, right? So we need to embed paid advertising into your strategy. So look into this update. I hope we served you. I hope we gave you some new strategies that you can embed into your plan for your business so that you can keep zooming forward. Our goal is to help you double your revenues in under 12 months. And any way we can help you do that, if you're looking for a job, yeah, you should apply. Okay, you should reach out to us. If you're looking for someone to handle your marketing, you can reach out to us as well. Or if you're looking for some coaching, you can always reach out to SMB Team, because we're here to make you double.
Absolutely.
Like that.
Before we go here, make sure you click on the link below that has a special tool that we're giving away to you just for watching this video that will help you learn the best advertising strategy to use right now.
Stay great. We'll see you in the next video.